Mark Spitz in Munich in 1972. If he does not win gold in this race tonight, that quest is over, but he would still be alive for his hopes of 8 total medals and matching Alexander Dityatin, the Soviet gymnast in 80 for the most medals in a single games. Let's check the lanes. In lane one, Emiliano Brambilla of Italy. He's been in a lot of finals in 3 Olympics, but he's never had a medal. He's been fourth 4 times. There is Grant Hackett. He could just steal the show from everybody. The 24-year-old Aussie took silver behind the torpedo in the 400 free earlier. And there is Michael Phelps. Just took off the headphones, but we understand the rapper of choice for these games is Eminem. And there is the man that really, if you look at it on paper, Rowdy, would seem to be the favorite. The defending gold medalist, Pieter van den Hoogenband, now 26 years old, doesn't swim a lot internationally, but when he shows up, he swims big.
Well, certainly has a lot of speed, and he'll use that early.
And next to him in lane 5 is Ian Thorpe. A gold medal in this race would give him the most, 5, in Australian Olympic history. So there might be some serious thunder down under if Thorpe touches first after 4 lengths of the pool.
So much at stake for him.
Don't forget about the other American, Cleet Keller. He is a medal contender in lane 6, won his 2nd straight Olympic bronze in the 400 earlier in these games. Next to Keller in lane 7, Simon Burnett of Great Britain, ranked 12th in the world in this event. And over in lane 8 is Rick Say of Canada, 7th in this event in Sydney. But back to Pieter van den Hoogenband. Rowdy, why would he be considered perhaps the favorite? Just because of the fast time he swam earlier today?
On that, and the fact that he just has the speed. He outsplit Thorpe and Thorpe and Phelps by over a second in their 400 freestyle relay last night. So you know he's gonna use that to his advantage. And look at that, Dan.
All 4 of them lined up in a row, all 4 world record holders, all of them Olympic champions, and they represent the 4 fastest times in history in this event.
Wow.
4 lengths of the pool to decide the Olympic medals. Hackett in lane 2, Phelps, van den Hoogenband, Thorpe. Keep an eye on Keller in lane 6.
Take your mark.
And off they go.
Ian Thorpe last off the blocks, but boy, he came up swimming in a hurry. He does not want Pieter van den Hoogenband to get too far away from him like he did in Sydney 4 years ago. He might have learned his lesson by staying out front early. You can see him right there.
What kind of race does Phelps have to race here up there in lane 3?
Well, there's no way he has the speed to match van den Hoogenband or Thorpe. He cannot panic. Use that early speed to try to stay with him as much as possible. Ride the hip of van den Hoogenband. He can come home against these guys, but he can't get out with them.
Van den Hoogenband had the lead. Thorpe was in 2nd. Thorpe's world record was 3 years ago. He was under world record pace, but it's still early. Van den Hoogenband has about a half body length lead over Thorpe as they make the turn at the halfway point.
My goodness.
Under world record pace, they continue to be.
2nd under world record pace.
And Phelps was in 3rd, so it's van den Hoogenband, followed by the torpedo, and then Michael Phelps.
You know, I think van den Hoogenband went out way too fast, 50.4. I just can't imagine him being able to hold that pace. You can see Phelps right there, starting to get inching up against that lane line. He's trying to catch much of a draft as possible.
Even though van den Hoogenband has the lead, the torpedo is right on him. And in fact, Thorpe beginning to pull away from van den Hoogenband. Phelps still in 3rd. Keller was in 4th, and Hackett was in 5th. Hackett's gonna have to get it going in lane 2. He doesn't seem to be in it. So here comes the torpedo.
Well, van den Hoogenband's not giving up, but he's gonna run out of room.
The torpedo, who had van den Hoogenband beat him 4 years ago, gets the gold. Van den Hoogenband gets the silver, and Phelps gets the bronze. A new Olympic record for Ian Thorpe. And Phelps keeps his hopes alive of matching that 8 medal total.
And that's an American record for Michael Phelps, but Ian Thorpe, what more can you say?
So we officially put to rest the talk about matching Mark Spitz's 7 Olympic golds, but Phelps, I mean, it was very possible, Ronnie, that he might not have got a medal here. He got it done.
I tell you, he did a great job of accelerating the finish. You know, it's speculative to say this, but I'm telling you, another 10 meters, and Michael Phelps was running down, not only Bond and Hoogenband, but Thorpe himself. That was a great swim by Michael Phelps to get the bronze, breaking that American record. He smashed his own American record. You see Thorpe at the top of the screen. What a great turn he had coming off that wall. He stayed underwater when Bond and Hoogenband came up and started stroking away. And you knew he had a lot left in those legs. And look at this, puts his head down, doesn't breathe the last three or four strokes. So Bond and Hoogenband really struggling to get in. And that is the Olympic champion. Wow.
Ian Thorpe with his fifth gold medal in his career gets it done against Pieter Bond and Hoogenband. Michael Phelps, who was under his American record time. Our Hall.